Hello everyone, Brett Settles with Revizto here for entry number 5 into our video series around clash automation. To kind of give everyone an overview of what this new workflow looks like. So, we've really covered in the last 4 episodes, or entries, the basis of clash detection or the building blocks of clash detection, which were the search sets and the properties and the metadata of all the objects. In the second one, we talked about the criteria and how to generate results from a test and how to set up all of that information. In the third entry, we really talked about working with those results, grouping those results, viewing those results in different ways. And in the fourth one, we talked about issue automation. Now in this one, I really want to talk about the one thing going on during coordination that isn't really part of the workflow. It is part of the workflow, but it's not really considered part of the technical written workflow, and that is the actual live meeting. Everything that we've discussed so far takes you from what we released with version 5.0 all the way through reporting, as any issue created from a clash will automatically be reported on like any other issue that we have in here. So, after covering that workflow, I wanted to dedicate one of these entries to the live meeting and the visibility aspects of what we've done here. So, we're going to cover that. Now, up here, I'm going to open up my clash automation dialog, and we'll see the different tests that we've been working with through this video series. And what we're going to see is over here, all of that criteria. As I go through the test and click on each test, I will see the difference of criteria, as well as issue automation. I think this is really important because if you notice with this one, there is no issue automation. So that means that if we create issues from this, everything will be default. As to where here, we are using a special electrical clash stamp with the correct assignee, priority, all of that. I think that's one thing that's really important is to understand these settings over here. And especially for this topic, which is viewing in a live meeting, exactly how we have all of these settings set up. Now, I'm not going to change any of these at the moment, but we can change these on the fly, and it will update all of your screenshots of that test without any sort of synchronization or any sort of computing process. Now, once I select on one of these, I can actually open that up, and you'll notice that I'm actually opening up a test that Sean Hester has checked out. And I think that this is really important because I can still view things even if I cannot edit them. And in the live meeting, this may actually be a critical part of that. So what I can do now is I can come in here and say, all right, what are we talking about today? How exactly are we looking at these issues? And so we're in the mechanical and structural test. So here I can actually see all of the clashes that we're still tracking down that issues have been created. Now you'll notice that as I click on each one, I instantly teleport from one to one or from one to the other. And it shows me exactly what is clashing there. Over on the right, this is where I can change my appearance. So if I come in here and change this to white, you'll notice that everything except for the clash turns white. And I can very clearly see that clash from pretty much all angles. Or I can go back to the mechanical versus structural appearance template. And there I can see the appearance template as it applies to mechanical and structural. If I need to go to this issue, I can actually click on the hot link here and it will take me directly to this issue. This is where I can get back to the clash if I need to, put in any notes, anything of this nature. How is the resolution going on this issue? Just like always, we can get right to our issue tracker, communicate with that team member, even right there in the meeting, and then jump back to the clash. So, another better example would be jumping into a clash as an issue, knowing that there's some critical documentation we need to attach, jumping into that issue and attaching that file. Another very, very good way that we could come in there and utilize that connection between the clash detection and the issue tracker. So, as I jump through there, very easy to look at issues that have already been created. Also very easy to tell if issues are false positives or not. So as we jump through some of these that have not been reviewed, we can toggle the view settings, see the different ways that we can look at the models, potentially isolate some of that information if we need to, and actually see what is going on. Okay, looks like we've got this item here from the mechanical shop drawings interfering with the most likely a slab or a grate on deck here. But anyway, going back, we can go and show everything, or we can even jump back here and once again change that appearance profile if we need to. Turn on the sectioning, very quickly see that section, and jump through all of those clashes with sectioning on. So very quick way to view these items. Now let's talk about viewing them in groups. Let's say that we're in this meeting and we need to talk about all of the items pertaining to level 7. I can quickly switch to level 7 and very quickly see all of the clashes that have been grouped and that are affecting level 7 right there. As we can see, some stretch through some of the building, and we can do that right there. So once that's done, we can then go in and vet and see if all these level 7 issues are indeed issues in any way, shape, or form. Once we're done with level 7, we can then go through and switch to level 8. As we can see now, we're automatically taken to all the issues on level 8. There we can see those in isolation. And there we can see all of those issues with any of the multiple appearance templates that we have. What's really great about this is the ability to work with the tools the way that you want to work with the tool. If you notice, a lot of this is very flexible. We've talked a lot about levels, but what about viewing in a particular room? So we can go through and say, all right, I want to see everything residing in, let's go ahead and say, the informal meeting room. So I can search for that. Informal meeting. I can select right there and immediately see those clashes that are in that area. If I want to change something that's going to give me, there they are. So switch there, get a good view of those, and then if we need to go back to any sort of coordination view, if we want to dim the unselected clashes, we can see that we can select this one, or this one, and see the others as dimmed, or we can even make them bright, or we can make them gray. So some predetermined options there, the ability not to even highlight them at all. If the section needs editing, we can edit that as well. So scaling the section box, rotating the section box in any sort of way that we see fit. If I want to get down there and section that off, I can do so and then save that viewpoint for those issues. Another very good one is by search sets. If we're looking for a way to reveal clashes that have to do with a certain scope, such as fire protection, I can reveal that very quickly. As I can see, nothing with fire protection. Let's move on to the hydronic supply. So we'll look for hydronic supply, and here we can see all the issues that have to do with that hydronic supply system. As we look out here, quickly manipulate exactly what we want to see. And there we can see all the hits. and we can begin to individually review each one. Once again, you can turn the section box off. If I want, I can lock the camera in the section box. And as you can see, I can even toggle through at a higher level view. See, there's a problem in the office. Let's go ahead and zoom out here a little bit more. There's the clash located there. So very easy to pinpoint where these clashes are, regardless of any way that you're using the information. Very, very important in that live meeting. Now, let's say that we want to create an issue out of this in that meeting and say, all right, well, everyone in the room has decided that we need to turn this into something. We can come right here. Let's go back out into a test that I can actually edit. So we'll go fire versus structure. Let's go electric versus structure. I will get rid of my filter here. I'll go ahead and check that out. All right, so here we go. So we're looking at this clash right here. And let's say that we want to create an issue from this. I can right click over here and actually sync this with the issue tracker. And now it'll ask me reviewed or reviewed and not reviewed. So here I have the ability to go back. And what I need to do is I need to make sure that I turn this to reviewed, and then I can go in, sync that with the issue tracker, one reviewed, and now we have an issue sent out to the right person, completely automated, with the ability to see all of those elements of the clash.